Okay, so the bulb on my lamp just went, so now I'm kind of having to use the light. Well, my normal light in my room. It doesn't work so well. Not as well as the lamp, but it's kind of my backup until I get a new light bulb for the lamp. I mean, the lighting isn't that great anyway coming from the lamp, but it's better than this. Oh well, it's no big deal. That's the thing, my room isn't exactly, it doesn't exactly have the best layout for if I want to record video, since my TV is on this wall and then behind me is a window. And if anybody knows about recording with, well, just recording with video cameras, then obviously having something with lights behind the subject is not a good thing, obviously. In which case I have the sun shining on the window, which right behind me, which is not a good thing. I forgot to call the helicopter.
Please select a land support helicopter. Roger. Requested.
Okay. Doing better than last time.
Complete.
An intel, but I don't think I can grab that guy. Well, not with my suppressor worn out anyway. I'll just draw everyone towards me like moths to a flame. Oh. I can't resist. Oh, I should have resisted. Could you use that invoice to escape? If you hadn't gotten spotted, of course. That would be an easy way out.
This is Pequot. Have arrived at LZ.
Okay, just hang on a bit for me.
Support helicopter has arrived.
Don't turn around, please.
Looks like the road's been sealed off.
How about just to the side, I think. There's a little gap right here. I don't think the D-Walkers will spot me. Otherwise, I'll just run for it. Oh, yep, I got no choice. He's coming. I think he's coming over. Yeah, I'm in trouble. Yeah, we're going nuclear. Maybe I should have hijacked that, the D-Walker. I shot the driver, so I think there's one other D-Walker. Yeah. Oh, I thought you were shooting at me. Come on, land. Oh, wait, it's quite. Yeah.
Watch out, boss.
A bit further away than I thought. Although, I think I'm in the clear. I think that's the first time I've seen it raining. Of course, it didn't rain in Afghanistan, obviously. I don't think I've even seen it raining at Mother Base, and I've spent quite a fair amount of time at Mother Base. What is that? Did my helicopter shoot that? I did actually like that mission quite a bit. It's just a nice change of scenery. Not only because we're in Africa, but what we had to infiltrate, it was just, it was something different. Kind of like that.
Exfiltrated.
All right, you're out of the hot zone. No enemy forces in pursuit. Mission complete.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base. Development project has been added.
Autoloader, what's that?
Mission complete. Boss.
I got a B for that. It's so weird, I think I'm doing really well, then they just give me something like a D, and then just then, I thought I was doing terribly, and they give me a B.
Took another look
like,
at
sure.
The owner of the oil field. They were behind what happened. They hired the PF, not UNITA. They restarted the facility all the while pretending they were the victims. One other thing. Singer's Johannesburg head office is just a room in a multi-tenant building. Company's essentially non-existent. 3 years ago, that investment fund stepped in and started gutting it through a series of mergers and sell-offs. And get this, the fund itself no longer exists either. It's a shell corporation, meaning someone is just using
some I wonder who.
Shadows. But what about those strange corpses? Just what the hell were they doing over there?
So the corpses are going to be people they were trying to convert into skulls, but they couldn't, for some reason,
Snake,
do it.
I've customized a walker gear.
Basically failed test subjects.
It features a silent running system, great for infiltration missions, and you can also summon it to your location. I've taken the liberty of calling it the D-Walker. It's armed with a suppressed tranquilizer gun. If you want to add other weaponry or upgrade the chassis, give the order from your iDroid.
Okay, sure. So I can now use the D-Walker if I want to. It's one of those things where I kind of just feel like playing as normal Big Boss. I don't really want to have to worry about all these other things I can use.
I've updated the mission list.
See that thunder?
We received a new job offer. It doesn't seem connected to Cypher or Skullface at all. But if it goes well, we may get an Afrikaans interpreter. The details are on your iDroid.
I will do that one, actually. Off camera, though.
Call that thing Sahelanthropus. Where does the name come from?
Well, several years ago, an excavation team discovered a hominid skull in the Sahel region.
Central Africa, the Southern Sahara.
Cypher gave the specimen the name Sahelanthropus, Man of Sahel. And then they covered the whole thing up.
Why?
They probably wanted to monopolize information about human evolution to have a head start in their genetic research. At least, until they had an idea of what they'd found.
It was that big of a discovery, huh?
Sahelanthropus was a gracile hominid, estimated to have lived about 7 million years ago. What's significant about it is how its skull's foramen magnum faces down. In other words, its spinal column supported its head from underneath.
It stood upright.
Right. Which would mean Sahelanthropus walked upright 3 million years before Australopithecus, making it the world's oldest human species.
Walking upright. I get it. Hence the name Sahelanthropus for your machine.
Walking upright was the decisive difference between our ancestors and other anthropoids. Our brains could get heavier once they were supported by the spinal column. That led to the use of tools and the development of complex communication through language. Only man is capable of this. My creation will be the progenitor of all bipedal weapon platforms.
And you did this for Cypher?
No, not at all. Sahelanthropus is the best proof that I never betrayed you guys.
What do you mean?
The reconstructed Sahelanthropus skull looked exactly like the skull we used as our logo 9 years ago in the Caribbean.
An army without a nation. Outside the world order.
The design was based on Pangaea, the supercontinent that existed 250 million years ago, right?
Yeah. When the world was a single landmass, that concept's at the source of our strength.
I felt the same way about Sahelanthropus. Sure, I was forced to build it under their orders, but I always wanted to put its technology back in our hands someday. That's the reason I incorporated the old insignia into Sahelanthropus' name. Don't you see? That's how much I was thinking about you guys.
Oh, I see, all right. I see someone desperate to cover his ass. You can say whatever you want after the fact. But that skull also symbolizes somebody else. Skullface.
Snake, you finally came. Just don't record this, okay?
Are they going to talk about Liaison Front Terrible? Did I say that right?
What I'm about to say stays between you and me. It's about the weapon to surpass Metal Gear. You know a researcher by the name of Clark?
Dr. Clark, yeah. Paramedic.
In the biotech industry.
It's not real a he, it's a she. Stuff.
His area is bioengineering, but lately he's also gotten into genetics.
Is he just mistaken this for a he?
Well then,
Dr. Clark.
What do you know about cloning?
I think I've heard enough.
Hold on, this is important. Cloning lets you create a...
Why is Shuri calling Dr. Clark a he? Does he not know?
You take the nucleus of one of its cells, and you swap it with the nucleus of an unfertilized egg from another member of the same species. They started out working with plants, but since then they've had success with other organisms, including mammals. It's a hot area for a lot of places right now. Corporations, universities, research groups. There's no shortage of scientists out to get famous and patent their work, with morality taking a back seat.
Isn't that a little outside your field?
It's got nothing to do with my research. But I thought it might be of interest to you. Cloning, and Dr. Clark, I mean.
Go on.
Now, this is really highly classified stuff. But I've heard that an American biotech company has successfully cloned a human being.
Yeah, big boss.
What's more, it happened over 10 years ago, and the researcher behind it was Dr. Clark. You've really never heard of him?
I don't meet many doctors.
This Dr. Clark is a complete ghost, even to others in his field. His age, where he comes from...
Big boss knows who Dr. Clark is.
And I can't even say for sure he's a he.
Yeah, he's a she, yeah.
Clark's employer, ATGC, its company motto is embracing your hopes, preserving talent.
Why is Big Boss pretending...
What does this have to do with me?
Cypher.
Is he pretending not to know Dr. Clark? As part of the interrogation?
DARPA. Cypher couldn't function without the communications network DARPA's built. Meaning, Cypher has to be a part of the Pentagon. Or at least, the two are joined at the hip. DARPA is a driving force behind human cloning. It's a pretty high priority project for them. And this Dr. Clark, some say he's a pivotal player in...
One of the founding members, you may say.
That's not all. Every cell nucleus in an organism contains the genetic information for that organism. Think of it as a blueprint for life. Clark appears to be working on how to decode this information and rearrange it at will. If you could do that, it would mean being able to custom design human beings for specific purposes. Can you believe that? Suppose for a moment that this is all fact. A man of your talents, if your genetic information died with you, that would be a terrible loss for mankind. But what if mankind could preserve you for future generations by cloning you?
All right, enough. I get the idea.
Look, I know it's inductive reasoning, but this weapon to surpass Metal Gear they're developing in Africa, I believe it's something that uses this new technology. Speaking as a fellow scientist, it chills me to the bone.
That's rich coming from you.
If genes serve as our blueprint, then
the whole reason Big Boss left the Patriots in the first place was because
can you imagine
was because
that?
Zero cloned him or was try or
that wants its children to
or because
it.
Zero was going to clone him. That's why Big Boss left the Patriots in the first place. So why is Big Boss pretend acting as if he's so clueless about this? Or are they retconning this?
It could be
this is either a plot hole or a retcon, or maybe Big Boss is pretending not to know what he's talking about as part of the interrogation.
It'd make a good movie.
Because they said in MGS4 the whole reason Big Boss left the Patriots was because of the Liaison Front Terrible. project.
I just overheard it in bits and pieces while I was forced to do that research for them.
Right.
Wait a minute. Look, I want to help you. I want to be of service here. I'm risking my life with this.
Is that so? Maybe it's time we brought someone else into the conversation.
Miller?
No, not him. Not Ocelot. You can't do this.
Because Ocelot is supposed to be some master interrogator. We established that in MGS1. They did say that in one of the Kodak frequencies. He's kind of known as the guy who loves to torture people and just... yeah. Before I do the next main op, which is that... oh wait, so getting the translator is not a side op, it's an actual main op. Okay, sure. Okay, so I just started the next story mission, which once again takes place in Africa, no surprise.
Several high-level British CFA officials are being held by their Afrikaner colleagues. One of these prisoners is the rescue target, a guy known as the Viscount. The target's location is unknown. They're bound to have an interpreter present when they interrogate him. We've used info from the intel unit to predict the interpreter's location. It's on your iDroid. Follow the interpreter and extract the target when you find him.
Check this out. Seems to be like some sort of swamp area. It's kind of cool. Let's go, D-Horse. 300 meters? This seems really close. Well, in comparison to the previous mission, where I had to travel quite a distance to get to the objective. What am I missing here? This seems to be pretty simple.
Enemy presence analysis complete.
Already? Oh, I have to. Oh no, it's gonna be one of these missions. Wait a minute. Is he gonna be driving across the map or something like that? And I'm gonna have to follow him.
Analysis complete.
That's not the target. Orders are only the Viscount gets rescued. Can't understand why he'd receive special treatment, but I don't imagine it'll be a problem to save the other prisoners too.
Can't I just grab the guy and just interrogate him? Wouldn't he give me the location then? As long as this doesn't involve him driving and me having to chase him on the horse, I'm going to be okay with this. For the most part. So then again, with these tailor missions, you just got to wait. It's kind of just slow and it's not really much going on. I'm never a fan of these kind of missions. I don't think much people are. Most people seem to bitch about these kind of missions.
They are all business. Hard to believe they're interrogating their own. Situation must be worse than we thought.
I mean, would it be a mission failed if I kill this guy? I'm sure I could search the surrounding area myself and find him. I don't think I need to tail this guy. But I'm thinking if I lay him out of my line of sight, maybe I'll get a mission failed though, so.
If you're going to use a weapon, be careful not to draw the enemy's attention.
What? Oh no. I already have drawn their attention. Oh no, they're walking on. Oh, nice. I thought it was all over. Sans lingua. I'm not sure what he says. You know in the trailer, Scarface has that line, sans lingua franca, something like that.
If he doesn't turn up, they won't be able to do the interrogation. If they then decide the target's no longer any use to them, they won't hesitate to kill him.
Analysis complete.
Hey. The prisoner you extracted wasn't the target, but we did get some information. Seems the prisoners aren't held together, and the cells and interrogation rooms are separate places.
Okay. Now we are in trouble. Did the guy on the left spot me as well? Alright, so this is my second attempt. Pretty much the same area that I just got spotted in.
Analysis complete.
I'll pass on him. I just realised my mother base is actually getting... Basically, all of my departments are completely filled up, so... At this point, I just need to get more materials so I can build more platforms. Because the more platforms you build, the more staff members you can house at Mother Base. So, I'm in trouble. Well, it's not that big of a deal, but it's kind of annoying having Mother Base completely full. Just knowing that you can't recruit any more new soldiers. Well, you can recruit them, they just go to the waiting room. But eventually the waiting room itself will become full, so... It's a bit concerning. Is this the place?
That's not the target. Orders are only the Viscount gets rescued. Can't understand why he receives special treatment, but I don't imagine it'll be a problem to save the other prisoners too.
What's the cause?
You found the interpreter. Now follow him to the target.
No, don't do this. Are we gonna Oh, are they following me? No. I guess they're going to the target now. I thought they saw me and they were coming to investigate. I guess not. And I'm glad that they're not. Alright, so I finally found the guy. This is like my third attempt. I'm not sure what was going on. Basically, the guy I'm supposed to follow found one of my dead bodies, or unconscious bodies. He freaked out, and it seemed as if he was refusing to lead me to the target because he came across an unconscious body. So I ended up just searching the surrounding area for about 20 minutes. And it looks like I finally found the target, so I'm glad this mission is over. It took me a long time, but I got there in the end. That was really annoying. I hate tailor missions, and this is no exception. It seems as if the guy's AI messed up because he came across one of my unconscious bodies. But it should still be able to fix itself, you know? Fine. Oh, and that'll be the final task. I did find a bunch of other prisoners as well, that I saved. So I guess they were part of the mission tasks. And I'm assuming this is the final mission task. Hang on, I just want to manage my auto ops right now. 27? Cool. What's this? Ah.
Complete.
Ooh, I think they're both worth taking. Oh wait, my bad. It's just the one guy. The other guy can stay.
Analysis
Is the weather... Yeah, the rain may affect this. Oh, it's 90%. It's fine. I'll take the chance. I'll just get rid... Yeah. Well, that mission was a pain in the ass. It's only because the guy I'm supposed to be following found an unconscious body. It seemed to mess up his... the AI path, the... whatever. It seemed to mess it up.
Yes, mission complete.
I got an A rank for that.
Boss, one of the other British prisoners filled us in about the Viscount. It turns out he's a real two-faced son of a bitch. He was planning to secure the MPLA's oil field rights for himself in exchange for swapping the CFA's alliance from the anti-government UNITA rebels to the state-backed MPLA. He hid this from the Afrikaners, but once he thought the jig was up, he tried to pin it on the other British personnel and take off. The Afrikaners captured him, and that was when he asked us to rescue him, and only him. I'll throw him in the brig for now, but we may have to be extra persuasive with this one. By the way, boss, we got some interesting news out of our friend the Viscount. He mentioned that more than a few PFs in the region have purchased Walker gears. The CFA's the same. That's Soviet Army technology, and it's still a prototype. Only Cypher could be leaking it to the PFs. But the question is, why?
Indeed.
This could be our chance to close in on Cypher. Take a look at your mission list.
Please select a mission.
Eliminate all the Walker gears. That sounds like it may be tough. Yeah, I think I should bring my rocket launcher to that one.
Boss, one of the latest missions to come in is connected to the Walker gears. This could be our chance to close in on Cypher. Take a look at your mission list.
Steve, how many of those bipedal weapons have popped up around Africa?
When did that start?
No more than 6 months ago. Didn't really hit me until I came here.
They're not supposed to be in use yet. Emmerich says they were still doing the last round of fine-tuning.
The doctor has no idea. His research has already hit the black market. Both sides of the Iron Curtain will have it by now. Even so, they're spreading much too fast. Sure, the Walker gears can operate in any terrain. Their mobility's just as good in the jungle as it is in the desert. That would come in handy in a place like Africa. They are modules that can one day be used as nuclear weapon systems. And with that in mind, the numbers are way too large. There must be another reason they're so widespread.
Like what?
It's all about needs. To small-time outfits like most of these private forces, this product is a dream come true. Hell, it goes beyond PS. This is the ultimate weapon, the forbidden fruit, for anyone with an enemy to fight and people to defend.
A nuclear deterrent.
Exactly. Sounds familiar, huh? PFs are all operating off your playbook. You created these times. But could this be the new weapon in Africa that Emmerich talked about? If it is, why is Cypher letting everyone and his brother get their hands on one? What comes next? Selling nuclear weapons in the open? Making them public property?
Why don't they give that a try? Then the next war really will be fought with sticks.
Right. The man we're dealing with isn't foolish enough to make a suicide pact with the world.
So, what is Cypher really up to?
Mission accepted.
Okay, so mission 15, Footprints of Phantoms, as it says. So we've got to destroy a bunch of D-Walkers. That's what I can gather from the description of the mission.
This contract comes from the People's Movement for the Liberation of Angola, also known as the MPLA. The PF at Ditati Abandoned Village has been supplied with Walker gears. Your job is to eliminate them all. Destroy them, extract them, whatever you see fit. This just might get us closer to the Walker gear supplier, Cypher. Good luck, boss.
So at least this mission is kind of relevant to the story. I mean, it's loose. It's loosely relevant to the story, but that's good enough, I guess.
Be careful down there, boss.
So it basically sounds as if this one is going to be really action-orientated. As opposed to the stealth. I mean, eliminating the D-Walkers, you're just gonna blow them up, right? I guess you could tranquilize the guards, the drivers, but I don't know. But this one is, I feel like, kind of just going nuclear, I guess. Oh, why did I abandon the horse? I do like that sunrise. That sunrise looks pretty nice. Yeah. By console standards, it looks nice. So what am I doing here? I'm just destroying D-Walkers?
Analysis complete. Yeah.
The targets have been deployed to that outpost. Find and eliminate.
So maybe I can sneak up on them, perhaps.
Clouds approaching.
So I definitely want this guy.
Take me.
Okay, prisoners, cool.
The map has been updated.
Hope no one's nearby.
He's coming too. Roger that.
Analysis complete. Analysis complete.
Again, this guy is probably going to trigger the reflex mode.
Has been updated. Analysis complete.
Oh, great. I was a bit concerned this guy would come over to investigate the sighting, but it's all good so far.
Ready.
And speaking of the prisoners, where are they then? If he marked them on my map. Okay, so it's kind of to the right. Okay.
Analysis
ready good?
Nope. Complete.
I have fault-tuned a lot of those heavy machine guns,
complete.
So I'm not gonna bother
analysis
grabbing
complete.
Any here. That's the first thing I did when I upgraded the photon to the point where it can pick up weapons such as those machine guns. That's the first thing I was doing. I just went around the map grabbing as much as I possibly could. Now I have I'm pretty sure I have a very decent supply of them.
Huh?
where your friends are.
Oh, there's two prisoners? Okay. I still haven't found a single D-Walker. I'll fault on the guy in a moment, but... seems a bit risky right now. Shall I do it? I'm here to save you. I think I hear music. Is it radio? The guys at this outpost don't seem to be well equipped. The guys in the previous mission were at least wearing night vision goggles or thermal goggles, something like that. These guys, they don't even have helmets. Not that I'm complaining. I'm fine with that. I think that hit him just not on the head.
And caution, rain approaching.
A very welcome addition to my army. And this was the good guy, yeah? Hey. Oh, okay, hang on. Someone. Oh, there he is. He's got a helmet. First helmet I've seen here. Ah, oh, the D-Walkers. Are there people on these things?
That's a target. Eliminate it any way you'd like.
What if I grab it? Can I capture this? No? Oh, I can. Sweet.
Analysis complete.
There's only two of them? I don't think I know that song. Blueprints. Oh, at least it wasn't for a shield. I found so many blueprints for shields and I was just like, I don't want these. I'm never going to use these riot shields or whatever they are. Don't get me wrong, I'm still there. I'm sure they are helpful in certain situations, but it's just not my style, so I'll pass. Mission task? Oh yeah, that was the prisoner.
Leave the rest to us.
Oh, this is decent. Grab him. I know, I'm kind of just running around like an asshole, getting spotted all the time. Just relying on reflex mode. I know a lot of people would call me a scrub, I'm sure. And maybe you're right.
Leave the rest to us.
Is this guy any good?
Analysis.
Yeah, he's decent.
Nice work. Keep it up. Great. No targets.
Oh, cool.
Your objective's complete.
That's it. That was a really short one. That may be the shortest mission yet. Although I'm kind of glad that mission was really short and sweet, because after the previous mission I was kind of burnt out. I'm sure I edited out most of that mission, but I'm telling you, it took me a long time. So like I said, the guy you're supposed to follow, he saw one of my unconscious bodies. So after he saw that, he basically freaked out and he was refusing to lead me to the guy I was supposed to find. So I was just running around for ages trying to figure out where to go. That mission was nice though, straightforward. That was fun. S rank. Cool. So why are they selling the D-Walkers to these guys?
Once you'd eliminated those walker gears, a resupply call was made from Ditati to CFA headquarters. The CFA then contacted none other than Saner. That's right, the shell company that owned Mvinda Oilfield. So Saner was just a front for Cypher. The resupply won't be happening just yet. But we did learn that the walker gears are transported out of Nova Braga Airport. Apparently, there's a distribution network on the Savannah that links all the PF outposts. I'll have the intel team investigate this network. If Cypher is supplying PFs with walker gears, the PFs have to be offering them something in return. We follow the money trail.
we might just find ourselves on Cypher's
doorstep. Guessing possibly something to do with the Child Soldiers. Maybe they are offering them the Child Soldiers. Of course, you saw them in the trailer. I'm not sure. In the trailer, you saw those kids in the cave, and Big Boss was about to kill them. Because I still don't know what is up with that scene. I haven't had that spoiled for me. So I'm kind of wondering about that. I am curious.
Team has come back with its report following its investigation into PF logistics. Cypher has to be involved with this distribution network somehow. One thing in particular caught my eye. A convoy that regularly crosses the Savannah. On paper, it's just mined resources going to the government. But the security's much too heavy. At the very least, it's worth checking out. Take a look at the mission.
Please select a mission.
Extract the cargo. Extract the cargo a convoy is transporting to Cypher.
Mission accepted. The map has been updated.
Okay, just reached the mission start point. So I'm guessing there's going to be a truck and I basically have to stop it, I guess. It's going to be something like that. Just stop it and steal the cargo. So it sounds like this one's going to be a really short one again.
Boss, your objective is to steal an entire truck from a PF convoy. We don't have a fix on the truck we want. But the intel team has spotted the unit that's been tasked with escorting it. They're stationed at the guard post to the north of Nova Braga Airport on the Savannah. The rendezvous with our target will be any time now.
Hey, so I'm guessing the skulls will pop up in this mission.
Then follow the escort unit. It should lead you right to the target truck. Boss, extract them from the mission area.
The skulls popped up in the credits then, in case you missed it. Two guys.
Analysis complete. Analysis complete.
Fairly useless.
Analysis complete. Analysis complete. Analysis complete.
I always thought the skulls roam the map at random and you could encounter them doing free roam outside of missions, but I'm not sure if that's true or not, because that's what I've heard, but I've never once come across them. And I did free roam in Afghanistan a lot. I haven't done much here in Africa, but off camera I did do an insane amount of free roaming in Afghanistan, but I didn't encounter them once.
We must be too late. Is there anything there that might lead us to the target? Look everywhere in the guard post.
There's got to be something in this tent, some intel, or the house. It's going to be one of these buildings. That's a pretty close call. Intel, I see it.
I'm putting the escort unit's predicted route on your iDroid. Get after them. They should rendezvous with the target soon.
Where are your friends?
I already got the intel file. A bit late on that. Unless there's another one. Let's see. No, I didn't mark anything. So he was talking about the intel file that I just got. Okay, so it's a pretty long route. I don't know where to begin. Let's go over here, I guess. Wait, he said it. Yeah, the airport. They said that it's going to the airport, so I'm thinking maybe I should just wait there. Realized he was moving. Well, good. So, let's get the horse. I haven't tried out the Ewoker or the dog as buddies because I don't know. I just, it doesn't seem like they would be that useful. I'm sure I'm wrong about that, but I don't know. I just don't really feel like commanding the dog around. However, if there's one buddy I would like to try out, it is Quiet, but unfortunately I haven't been given the ability to use her yet. And I feel like I'm a decent distance into the game, so I'm surprised that it hasn't been unlocked yet, the ability to use Quiet. So like, how late in the game does that pop up, the ability to use Quiet? Because there's 47 missions, I think, if I remember right. And what is this, mission 16, I think? So I'm a decent distance into the game, you know? Is this the rendezvous point? So they are probably meeting by here. Maybe I should head off in this direction.
Whoa. You can view the escort unit's predicted route on your map. The target should link up with them somewhere along it.
Those two are really the only ones worth keeping. I'm gonna hope the truck is coming from this direction, and I'll hopefully hijack it before it gets to them. So I'm going left here, I think. Oh, I'm going. Well, I just found the airport. Looks pretty fun. I mean, I want to sneak through it. I mean, looks like it could be fun to sneak through. I just went all the way down this route, and I didn't find the truck. I will admit, I didn't go to the very end. I basically stopped by there, and I was thinking, yeah, I'm not gonna sneak through that area. I was too lazy to do that, so I backtracked, and now I'm heading down the opposite direction. And I'm hoping the truck is somewhere down here. And then, yep, I see it. What to do? What to do? Come on. That takes care of the truck, not so much the tanks. Stop.
The enemy's on combat alert. Now that they know we're chasing them, the target will make an end run to its destination. Hurry up and find that truck.
Well, that is the truck. I found it. What's Miller talking about? Oh, God.
You're going to extract him.
What, dude? No! Is the horse dead? Not permanently, right? I don't know about this. I'm restarting that. I'm not sure if that means the horse is dead permanently, because somebody said that online, that if the horse dies, it's dead, it's gone forever. That sounds like bullshit when I think about it, but just, I don't want to risk it, just in case. I got a new plan. I'm going to be sure to shoot the driver off that truck, and I will do it with lethal means. Yeah, trying to track the driver of these trucks doesn't seem to work out well. It never worked out well before.
go on.
The darts from the tranquilizer gun don't seem to break the glass, the windscreen, or the trucks either. I know that from past experience, so I don't really want to try that again. Maybe if you shoot the windscreen enough times with a tranquilizer dart, maybe it will eventually break it, but I don't really have the time to do that. I just need to take this guy out ASAP. Headshots too. Alright, so we can confirm. I hate these tanks. They're pretty scary, to be honest. Pretty intense. Is he gonna Oh, okay, I wasn't expecting them. Well, I wasn't expecting them, but I wasn't expecting them to come out of that. What is up with that suit? Okay. Well, we know what the cargo was. They haven't seen me yet. I don't know where to begin. Tranquilizer guns are useless against them, I'm assuming. Rocket launchers are decent. We found that out with the honeybee weapon. I really don't know what's... They seem to be walking down the road, so maybe I can sneak up behind them and take the truck that way. That guy's facing me. Do they know where I am? It's as if they are coming towards me slowly. Of course, they will just go apeshit if I get too close. Maybe I could try blowing them up with the tank. I might regret this. Okay. I gotta be careful not to blow up the truck though, so I need to... I'm really not sure about this. What the... this is kind of spooky. Here we go, I'm gonna do it. And it blew up the truck, I think. Okay, let's try again.
The Scott. These bastards are pulling guard duty. That cruiser cargo is headed to Cypher.
It seems as if the tanks... Whoever's piloting these tanks get the hell out again, that out of this area. As soon as the skulls arrive. They're like, nope, we're not. We're out of here. I didn't mean to do that so early. I should have marked them before I began this. Where have they gone? I hear them, I don't see them. Okay, this one. That's a much better camera. This one doesn't have a rocket. I'm not sure what you call it. Oh, whoa, I killed one of them, I think. I'm assuming that's what the mission task was. This is gonna blow up anytime now. Get in the tank. Shoot. It's loaded. You know what this is reminding me of? Infamous. With the shards coming out of the ground. I'm actually not big of a fan of Infamous, but just making an observation. Alright, one of them's hanging around by the truck, so I can't shoot him. Or not, there's three of them back here. I think I prefer the machine gun, to be honest. Yeah, they move exactly like Quiet, so Quiet is obviously some failed skull experiment. She probably managed to escape when they were trying to experiment on it. That's what I'm guessing. Run him over. One left. Oh, whoa, is that all of them? And who's that guy? Oh, I think he was the driver. Sweet. Oh, okay, so you don't kill them. They kind of just flee. Okay. Get out of here.
Exfiltrated hot zone.
You're out of the hot zone. No enemy forces in pursuit.
That was a fun mission. I mean, trying to find the truck was pretty annoying, I think. I don't see why they don't just give you the location of the truck. It's not very entertaining going up and down that route trying to find the convoy. It's just like, just give me the location. I don't really understand what's the purpose of not just giving me the location straight off the bat. But yeah, the little battle with the skulls towards the end there, that was fun. I like that.
Amazing. Mission complete. That right there is why...
They gave me an S rank for that.